offers a variety of templates, perfect for newcomers to world development. In this tutorial, we'll be using the most basic Obby jump map template. You can download the Obby template from the link in the video description or from the official guide page. Scroll through the terms of use and click the Agree button to proceed with the download. After the download is complete, locate the zip file and extract its contents. This step is essential for running the project in Unity. Now, let's go back to the Unity Hub. Since we'll be working with the Obby template, let's close the current project. Simply click on the Close button, then hit the Add button and locate the folder you previously extracted. Here's a crucial step. Don't select the folder right away, but enter the ZEPETO Obby template folder, then click Open once you see the Asset folder. Wait a few moments and the Unity Editor will launch. Double-click on the Obby scene file to open it, and just like that, you're all set. To understand the Obby template, let's play it first. To play as your ZEPETO character, you must be logged into your ZEPETO account within the Unity Editor. Start by clicking the down arrow in the center menu to open the secondary menu. From the secondary menu, click on the Login button. This action will open the Project Setting ZEPETO Service window, offering three login options. Email. Enter your ZEPETO account email or ZEPETO ID. Phone. Enter your ZEPETO account phone number. QR. Utilize the ZEPETO app's scan QR function. For this demonstration, let's choose the email option. Enter your username and password, then hit the login button to proceed. If your login was successful, you'll notice a list of world names created by ZEPETO Studio within the ZEPETO service window. Simply choose a world name from the list and click the Link to Selected World button. Congratulations! You've now completed the login process. Remember, for future Unity world development, ensure to log into your ZEPETO account and link your world accordingly. Now, press the Play button at the center of the Unity interface. Your ZEPETO character should appear on the screen. Navigate through the obstacles and aim to reach the destination. Well done! We've reached our goal. Now it's time to create our own Obby world based on this template. Let's familiarize ourselves with the screen components of the Unity Editor to begin creating our own world using the Obby template. Firstly, we have the scene view and game view in the center of the screen. The scene view is where you can edit your scene by placing and deleting objects. You can navigate this view by moving the camera using a combination of mouse and keyboard controls. Typically, arrow keys are used for movement, while holding down the right mouse button allows you to adjust the camera orientation. You can also zoom in or out using mouse scrolling. Above the scene view are toolbars that enable you to move, rotate, and scale objects. On the left side of the screen, we have the hierarchy, which contains all the elements of your scene. Clicking on the default platform will display the object in the scene view, and double-clicking brings it into focus. The tools around the selected object, called gizmos, allow you to manipulate its position by dragging the arrows. Also, on the right side while an object is selected, you'll find the inspector, displaying the properties of the selected object. Each object has different properties, and we'll cover how to change these later. The game view serves as a preview or launch screen. When you press the play button, the editor automatically switches to game view. Finally, at the bottom is the project window, where all files used in developing the Obby world are organized and managed. Think of it as similar to the Explorer on your computer, where you can create, rename, or delete folders and files. Now that we're familiar with the basic Unity interface, let's focus on modifying specific areas of this Obby template, the platforms and the Zepeto players parts. We won't be directly modifying the logic-related execution areas. Currently, the platforms are categorized into different groups. The spawn group is where the character is initially spawned, so there is only one of these. Normal platforms are called static group. Moving group platforms move back and forth. Stepping on checkpoint group platforms sets a checkpoint. If you die, you'll respawn at the most recently visited checkpoint instead of starting from the beginning. Platforms in fall group fall after a period of time when stepped on. Stepping on trap platforms triggers a bounce and takes you to the most recently visited checkpoint. Goal group is responsible for displaying the ending screen when you reach the goal platform. This concludes our walkthrough of the Obby template scene.